What's up, travelers? In part two of touring Castel Sant'Angelo, we continue where we left off as we head up to the upper levels of the castle. If you haven't seen the first video, click on the card up to the right. So this area here was finished in the late 1500s, and it was commissioned by Pope Paul III, who also commissioned Michelangelo to paint the famous painting on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel, The Final Judgment. Look out here. Originally, you could see as far as the eye could see, it was just marshes and fields. Would have been something cool to see, I think. The frescoes that we're seeing are mostly depiction of Hadrian's career, including building this mausoleum itself. In the 1540s, Pope Paul III had this room completed, and it was painted by one of Raphael's students. This is the library. What a beautiful place. It was influenced by Nero's garden. Some say that this is Hadrian's real burial chamber. This is where you can find the emperor's sarcophagus, porphyry, of which only the cover has survived to the current day. Currently the baptismal font of St. Peter's Basilica. Originally this room was formed a single space with upper one, the so-called sala rotunda. The current division dates back to the Middle Ages. In the middle of the 16th century, Paul III had the room filled with walnut cabinets to house the papal archives as well as the secret archive. This is how it assumed its current day polygonal shape. This is Pope Paul III's bedroom. In the throne room. Imagine an old guy sitting there. And then his entertaining room. This room's painted with all kinds of paintings of Hadrian and Alexander the Great's conqueror.
Unbelievable.
And then when you exit the entertaining room, you get that view. Well, that's been the tour of Castel Sant'Angelo, Hadrian's Mausoleum. If you've enjoyed it, please like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and we'll see you in the next one.